for tuning in. This is OptiBotomsQuint with another video review. And today we're going to be taking a look at the new 6-inch version of Gandalf the Grey from the new Hobbit line. Now, Gandalf is arguably one of the most influential characters throughout all the Lord of the Ring movies, the upcoming Hobbit movie, and this really should be the definitive figure that we've gotten. Newest technology, newest movie, all that stuff. This really should be the best of the best. Now, I will say that I'm already concerned when you look at his robes, because these are very heavy looking, and it really does not look like there's going to be much articulation in his arms at all. And that really does make me concerned. I can't tell if that's a very soft rubber or anything. This bit right here moves fairly easily in the package, so hopefully that's very soft. We'll get to it here in a little bit. But obviously he comes with his staff, his hat, Glamdring. You got a nice picture of Sir Ian himself, of course, Gandalf the Grey. Flip around here. On the back, you got other 6-inch characters that are currently in the wave. You have Bilbo, Thorin, Toriel, and of course Legolas. Brief read up here on the Hobbit movie, as well as a read up here about Gandalf the Grey. Now, Gandalf really doesn't look that much different in terms of his age. It's really kind of nice, and then the sculpting on here absolutely looks fantastic. But like I said, my biggest concern is what's going to happen with these robes. How is his poseability? What's his articulation going to be like? That's all something that we're going to have to see. Hopefully the Bridge Direct hasn't really let us down, but packaging-wise, wonderful looking. You got the beautiful mural kind of Middle Earth. Real nice kind of bubble package here. Obviously, The Hobbit Unexpected Journey, the first of the new trilogy movies. So let's get this guy open, keep our fingers crossed, and see how cool he actually is. Alright guys, so here we have Gandalf opened up and out of its packaging. And my initial fears really have been both confirmed and rejected. One of my biggest concerns was looking at the overall sculpt of this. I really thought that this entire kind of outfit form would be very hard plastic. And it is, and it isn't. The really cool thing, getting a staff out of the way for right now, and I mean, you got a really nice staff. This is very accurate looking. I love the way that this looks. This outer bit here is all very soft, and it completely removes, and that is absolutely fantastic. He wobbles. He's a wobbler. This is all very soft, kind of pliable rubber, so this is absolutely wonderful. I was so worried that this was all going to be just hard plastic. Now, the rest of his outfit is still a little bit harder of a plastic, but it's definitely not as flexible as this. But it really doesn't affect things too terribly much. It's a lot like what we got with the 3 3/4 inch one. At least when it comes down to the kind of plastic that they used and such. I mean, it's really, really not all that bad. And like I said, I was initially terrified because I didn't think his arms were going to be able to move at all. Now, Gandalf really is probably my favorite figure in this new 6-inch line. I absolutely love the way that this guy looks. He does come with his wizard hat, and it just kind of sits on there. It doesn't stay on there too terribly well, but you can see that it's actually molded to fit in a specific way. So it does just kind of rest there, but it does give a very wizardy kind of look and feel to him. Now, his articulation is a little bit more limited because, again, you got this plastic bit here, and I kind of have a hard time with his feet getting them actually positioned. It's not bad. I mean, he stands perfectly fine. Just sometimes you have to position it just right so that it works. Kind of reach up in there and kind of manipulate the feet a little bit to get them to actually stand. Beyond that, though, absolutely wonderful. Now, like I said, he's got his wizard hat. He's got his... This is almost more like a traveling cloak kind of thing. Most of the time, we see him dressed like this. Now, he does come with his staff, as I mentioned. Very nice. Absolute beautiful detail. But he also comes with Glamdring. Now, this is the sword that I was talking about in my review of Thorin being the mate sword to the Orcrist. And absolutely beautiful looking sword. Now, one thing that's kind of interesting is in my reading, they talk about how this was made by the elves, and it was made in the same kind of way that Orcrist and Sting were, in the fact that the blade would glow blue when orcs were near. This was never something that we actually saw glowing in any of the movies. And, well, specifically the Lord of the Ring movies. I'm not sure if it's going to do that with The Hobbit, but you come around here to the side, and he's got a very long sheath that... And it's very hard plastic. that just slides right down there, and you can display that nicely. But that's really kind of attached to his body. I don't think that's coming off or anything. Now, the likeness on this is really very nice. Coming in here, this might be, at least for me, one of the best sculpted figures that we've gotten so far. And to me, really does capture the likeness of the actual actor, Sir Ian. Now, obviously, he, you know, it's got his big giant wizard beard and his hair and everything. But look at the detail on here. Just absolutely wonderful looking detail all the way throughout. This is a very soft kind of a rubbery plastic as well. And that's kind of like a scarf or something. But coming down through here, absolutely gorgeous. And you got his boots right down there. But very nice looking figure nonetheless. Everything about this guy just really does kind of impress me, huh? Now, the biggest negative, again, with the way that they're doing the hair and the actual wardrobe and such, very hard plastic, and that really is very unfortunate. Gandalf's head cannot do anything. That's about as much turning as you're going to get, and that's really unfortunate. This is very hard, so it really is kind of sucky. The shoulders will rotate forward and back. They rotate all the way around. Very big pin and socket joints here. I mean, you can see that here. I mean, this entire arm is really big, but forward and back all the way around. The wrists also rotate. He rotates at the waist. And then underneath here, you can kind of see it. He's got hip articulation, but you're not going to get much with it. He also bends at the knee, which, again, you're not going to get much with it because just the sculpt of the body. The ankles here move forward and back, and they also rotate. So you can get him to stand. He doesn't have a problem standing, but his articulation, while still very good, like all these figures are, the posability is, again, unfortunately, limited, just based on the design choices of some of the plastic that's used. I would have loved it if they actually used this kind of plastic for his hair or something. Then with this, you just drape this over him, and you can kind of see that the hair actually comes out from the body. So you just tuck that kind of underneath like so, do a little moving and finagling here, and now you can get him with his kind of travel robes, I guess, you know, just adds a little bit more warmth to the figure. But I mean, that is absolutely wonderful. I totally dig the way that that looks. Now, the unfortunate thing is his wrists, they don't move kind of up and down, so it's kind of weird to get his staff posed with him, because really and realistically, this is the arm that he would hold his staff in. He held it in his left hand. That's just kind of the way it goes. I mean, I guess you could put it in his right hand here, but that's not the hand that he held it in, and that hand is a little bit better for it, but again, not too terribly accurate to the realism, I suppose. But nonetheless, absolutely wonderful looking figure. As I said, this is probably my absolute favorite of the 6-inch figures, and rightly so. I mean, this is a very nicely done figure, and you got that on there. I mean, this just really kind of gives him more of a look, something that we saw in the Fellowship of the Ring. And we might see this kind of look again when he's traveling to meet Bilbo in the Hobbit movie, which we'll find out very, very shortly. Now, the only unfortunate thing is, like, when you put his arms down, this kind of bulges out like that, but it's not too bad. Overall, though, if you're collecting these figures, this is the best one, I personally think. Gandalf is one of those characters that really has kind of captured the imagination of a lot of people. I mean, he's a wizard, so naturally he's going to be kind of fun to watch and be entertained by. And at $15, this figure really is well worth it, if you ask me. The sculpt, the paint, all exquisitely done by the Bridge Direct. I can't give those guys enough credit. They did a wonderful job in creating these looks. The only unfortunate aspect is, like, some of the design choices, like the harder plastic. Now, I just don't think that translated too terribly well. I don't know their reasoning behind it, but like I said, I don't think it translated too terribly well and really kind of limits a lot of the other work that they put into things, such as the sculpting. Beyond that, though, without a doubt, I would recommend getting this figure all day long. If you could, if you only really could get a couple of these figures, Gandalf and Bilbo would probably be the best ones to get. And that being said, here is the little guy himself. So there you have it. Bilbo, Gandalf. I really hope that we see more figures from these guys in the 6-inch scale. I would love to get a Gollum figure. That might be a little bit of a stretch. I'm not sure if this is going beyond Wave 2 or what, but absolutely wonderful looking figures here. These are the two that are absolute must-haves in my opinion. But that's about it, guys. So thank you for tuning in. This has been Optobotomus. Keep in touch with me. Find out recent purchases as well as upcoming reviews all at facebook.com/teambottomus and twitter.com/optobottomus. And until next time, I'll talk to you later.